Hello, everyone. We are broadcasting live from the Big Sleazy inside the Terror Dome, where the fans have been drinking since Friday. Decked out in purple, green, and gold, screaming for some violent action.
Kind of like you last night on Bourbon Street, huh, Rip?
And last night never happened. Today's matchup features the two teams who survived the regular season and playoffs. Tonight, they go to war in the mayhem of a Motor City Maniacs battle, the Tokyo Terminators. Welcome to Mayhem Bowl Sunday. Harbo and Grim Blitro here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and see what the team captains have to say. And welcome to the NFL Mayhem Bowl. Grim Blitro with you here along with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr.
Hi, everyone. I can't wait for the commercials to start. That's always my favorite part.
We've got the biggest game of the year here, Bricks. Two teams battling each other in the ultimate battle of death.
Yeah, but those butt wiper beer commercials with the horses, they make me want to cry, Grim.
And it's first and 10. About a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and 10. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
First down and 5. Chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's first and 10. down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Receiver's pocket, and the defense gets a turnover. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that. Well, that's a strange penalty call right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
Nobody's making a lot of dollars.
And it's first and goal. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
A timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and 10. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a supersonic missile to his receiver. Caught for the first down. They use their second timeout, but they're running out of time. It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. And did your mother ever tell you don't run with a chainsaw? And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a down-ass guy than a speed thing, Brent. He's running from his team. This is clear.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. That kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
Oh, this guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. My
such a carving knife anymore, Brick. Second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. And so the Mayhem Bowl rolls into the third quarter, and we have a much closer score than experts had predicted.
Well, you know, the Pep Boys, Tammy, Joe, and Cliff, have much lower prices than you would expect for car repairs.
I thought one of those Pep Boys threatened to dip your balls in battery acid and remove your eyes with a rivet gun because you complained about their rip-off scam on the air.
I know what you're talking about, Green. They're great kids, honest businessmen, not murderous or sleazy at all.
Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
Oh, that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Second down in a very long. Pick up 7 yards on that play. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Super fumble. You've got to protect the ball better than that. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see it, Grim.
You know, you have to wonder if the original creators of the Doomsday AI programmed them to dance as a way to mock us as they took over, or if they taught themselves in the irradiated ruins of the old world. Either way, enjoy. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Second down and 2.
Ouch! What is this, Andy's wrestling?
First and 10. Nice run for 5 yards. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Second down and 5. Thank you. Third down and five. Does the QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know where I'm at. You can't keep a good mutant down.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaur.
Must be opposite thing, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
And it's first and ten. Stuck to him like glue. Second down and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Third down and 6. And that's an incomplete pass. Looks like the defense got away with that one there.
I don't want to defend the receiver like that. He could get hurt.
Man, these guys have metal balls. They're going to try to pick up the first down here.
Do they jiggle when they run? You know,
it reminds me of painting a face. The unstoppable force meets the explodable object. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. Signals a hurry up.
Yeah, saving Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a
compliment. Oh, that gets me every time. Like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is going to blow. That's Cracker Pants Jr. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point in the game. Nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. They'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. Second down and 10. The defense is leaving the team with just one timeout, so they better bring the ball back gift wrapped.
Is it time for a ribbon or a ball, Grim?
Maybe if they use their last timeout. Conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And no more timeouts. The D needs a stop. This is intense.
intense. No, Grim, camping is intense. Get it?
Idiot.
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball's down.
And it's first and 10.
Brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so you...